Hello children, today we are going to start with the numericals, that is of exercise number 2A, right? We are going to proceed with the numericals. I want you all to complete the question answers of this particular exercise, that's from 1 to 25, okay? From 1 to 25 you can do, and even 26 you can write, 1 to 25 and 26. So let us see the first numerical which is there. The first few numericals are very easy, which you have already done in your previous classes. Speed of the car is 72 km per hour and you have to express in meter per second. Now to express in meter per second, either you can write it with like this, okay? So your speed of car is 72 km per hour, okay? So either you can write 1 km per hour, which will be equal to 5 upon 18 meter per second, okay? And here, or else the different technique which is given is you have to follow this technique, that is 72 multiply with 1000. How did I do this? That is 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meters, 60 into 60, that is seconds. So finally you cross multiplication, you will do, and you get the answer as 20 meter per second. Or else you can simply do by 5 by 18, that is 1 kilometer per hour equal to 5 by 18 meter per second. So 72 into 5 by 18, so 18 fours are 72 and 4 5s are 20 meter per second. Similarly, other two also I have done, that is 15 meter per second, you have to convert it in kilometer per hour. So same way, 15 into 18 upon 5, I did 1 meter per second if you want, so you have to multiply with 18 upon 5 kilometer per hour. So 15 multiply with 18 upon 5, which gives me 54 kilometer per hour, okay? So these are all the basics. Next one, kilometer per hour is there, okay? That's the third one. You have to express 1 kilometer per hour in meter per second. So 1 kilometer per hour will be expressed as 1 into 1000 upon 60 into 60, which is 10 upon 36, which comes about 0.2778 meter per second, 0.277 meter per second. Second one is 18 kilometer per minute. Okay, 18 kilometer per minute, you have to convert it into meter per second, very easy. 18 kilometer, which is 18 into 1000, okay, and down it will be only 60. We are not going to multiply 60 again because we have to already, it is in minute not in hours. So upon 60, which gives me 300 meter per second. So here you can see, so these are all the basics. So I went little fast with you. You already know how to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second and meter per second into kilometer per hour. So just go through these sums. Then fourth one I will not be solving, you will be solving it on your own, that is arranging the following speeds in increasing order. First you convert them in either one unit, either you convert them in meter per second or kilometer per hour, and then you find out the solutions, that which is greater. Now let us go to the fifth numerical. I'll be reading the fifth numerical. It states that a train takes 3 hours to travel from Agra to Delhi with a uniform speed of 65 kilometer per hour. Find the distance between the two cities. Very easy, right? What is the time taken by the train? 3 hours. Speed of the train, 65 km per hour. So what is the distance? What is the distance? Nothing but speed into time. Formula for speed is distance upon time. So formula for distance is speed into time, which is 65 multiplied with 3, which is 195 km. 195 km. Next one, the sixth numerical. Now in the sixth numerical, it is given that a car travels first 30 km with a uniform speed of 60 km per hour, okay, and then 30 km with a uniform speed of 40 km per hour. Okay, you have to calculate the total time of the journey and the average speed of the car. Okay, so let us see that for the first travel. Okay, when it is traveling for the first journey, it is traveling how much? 30 km in 60 km per hour. So distance 30 km, speed 60 km per hour. So T1, so the first time interval, distance upon speed, right, which is 30 upon 60. Okay, 30 upon 60 gives me 0.5 hours, or directly I can write here 30 minutes. Then for the second travel, what I have done? For the second travel, it travels again 40 km per hour in 30 kilometers. So speed equals to 40 km per hour and distance is 30 km. So T2, that is for the second time interval, distance upon speed, 30 upon 40, 3 by 4, 0.75 hours or 45 minutes. So total time taken will be 75 minutes, okay? The total time will be 75 minutes. How did I get as 75 minutes? By T1 plus T2. So what is the value of T1? 30 minutes, T2 45, which gives me 75 minutes. Now then, how will we calculate average speed? Average speed is total distance traveled upon total time taken. Total distance traveled we have 60 kilometers, right? Then total time taken 1.25 hours. Okay, we have to find out in kilometer per hour, so 1.25 hour. So 1.25 hour from where hours when from where did I get it? I just calculated it. Okay, here I just calculated the hours of it. Fine. Now next one. What are we supposed to find out here? So here 0.5 hours and 0.75 hours. 0.5 plus 0.75 giving me 1.25 hours. So since it's a decimal, so 6000 divided by 125, which gives me 48 kilometer per hour. So I hope you are clear. For the first travel, it was 60 kilometer per hour in 30 kilometers. So I found out T1, then I found T2. Total time T1 plus T2 gives me this answer. Average speed, total distance is distance 1, 30 kilometers, okay, plus 30 kilometers, 60 kilometer. Total time 0.75 plus 0.5 gives me 1.25. So answer comes as 48 kilometer per hour. Now the seventh numerical. Let us go to the seventh one. Now seventh one is the train takes 2 hours to reach station B. Okay. So here we can say that the train which is there, it travels from A to B. Okay. So the train takes 2 hours to reach station B. So it is taking 2 hours to reach and again 3 hours to reach it back. So from A to B, 2 hours, and from B to A it takes 3 hours to reach. So what is the total distance we are supposed to find out here? Now distance between these two stations is nothing but 200 kilometers. So 200 kilometer is the distance. Now we are supposed to find out average speed and average velocity. So now already I have found here what is the total distance, 400 kilometers. How 400 kilometers? A to B 200, B to A 200. So 400 kilometer. Total time taken, already we have 2 hours here, 3 hours here. So 2 plus 3, 5 hours is the total time. So total distance 400, total time 5 hours. So what is the average speed? Total distance travelled upon total time taken. So 400 upon 5, which gives me 80 kilometer per hour. I hope this is clear. Now, what will be the average velocity? Average velocity will be 0. Why 0? Because displacement is 0. How displacement is 0? Because train is starting from here, moving from A to B and coming back to B to A. What is displacement? Shortest distance travel. So the average velocity will be 0. Why? Because the train is traveling from station A to B and coming back from B to A. So average velocity will be 0 here. So I hope this numerical is also clear with you. Now let's go to the 8th numerical. 8th numerical is, a car is moving the straight path and covers a distance 1 kilometer due to the east in 100 seconds. Find the speed and the velocity of the car. Now suppose this car is traveling from this position and then it is traveling in the direction east. Okay. And the distance of the car is nothing but 1 kilometer and time is nothing but in 100 seconds it reaches towards the east. So we are going to find out the speed. So here we can see speed of the car, distance upon time. Distance I have taken here 1000. Why? Because it is 1 kilometer. 1 kilometer equals to 1000 meters. So 1000 meter upon 100 seconds, which gives me 10 meter per second. So the speed of the car will be 10 meter per second. What is the velocity? Now velocity of the car is nothing but magnitude of the speed with the direction, that is east. So here direction is specified. So constant, the velocity will be 10 meter per second only. Why? Because magnitude of speed is there, that's 10 meter per second. Direction is there east, so the velocity will be 10 meter per second. So I hope this is also clear with you. Let's proceed to the next one. Now 9th numerical, the body starts from the rest and acquires a velocity of 10 meter per second. Find the acceleration. Now when the body is starting at rest, so here initial velocity, that's u, will be what? 0 meter per second, right? Body starting from rest, that's why it's 0 meter per second. Initial velocity will be u. Final velocity, okay, what is the final velocity? It acquires a velocity, that means it is acquiring a velocity of 10 meter per second. 10 meter per second. So this will be what? The final velocity. This will be the final velocity. What is the time? 2 seconds. Time is 2 seconds. So what is the formula for acceleration? Acceleration is nothing but we can say that change in the velocity per unit time. So change in the velocity per unit time is final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. So acceleration will be v minus u upon t. What is the value of v? 10. What is the value of u? 0. 10 minus 0 upon 2 time 2 seconds. So it will be 5 meter per second square. Giving proper units to the number is very, very important. Acceleration's unit is meter second raised to minus 2. Velocities is ms raised to minus 1. This is very important. There are equal marks for the units, so don't forget to give the units. Acceleration is what? Change in velocity upon time, so final minus initial. So you should understand what is initial velocity first and what is the final velocity. Why I have taken 0 here? Because this car was at rest and then it acquired a velocity of 10 meter per second. Okay, now let's proceed further. Let us go to the 10th numerical. 10th numerical, a car is starting from rest. Again, the car is starting from rest. So what will be the initial velocity? 0. Okay, then a car is starting from the rest, acquires a velocity of 180 meter per second in 0.05 hour. You have to find the acceleration. So here, what is the initial velocity? So the car which is there, it's starting from rest, so 0 meter per second. Okay, and then it has acquired a velocity of 180 meter per second, so final velocity. So this is my u and this is my v. It started from rest, so initial 0, then acquired a velocity of 180 meter per second. Time taken is 0.05 hour, which has to be converted into second because here the units are in meter per second. How to convert? You should understand that. Now here meter per second is there, so I cannot keep this as hour. It has to be converted into seconds. So 0.05 into 60 into 60, which gives me 180 seconds. Why 60 into 60? This will give me only minute value, but this will give me the second value. Then what is the formula for acceleration? Change in the velocity upon time, final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. So 180, what is 180? Initial velocity, 0, 180, final velocity, 0, initial velocity. So 180 upon 180, which gives me 1 meter second raised to minus 2. This is the unit for acceleration. I hope this is clear. What is initial velocity? 0. Final velocity 180. Okay, this had to be converted into second. Just substitute the value, that is A is equal to V minus U upon T. So V minus U upon T gives me 1 meter per second square. Okay, now let's go to the 11th problem. 11th problem is that a body is moving vertically upwards and its velocity changes at a constant rate from 50 meter per second to 20 meter per second in 3 seconds. What is its acceleration? Now this body was at the ground and it was thrown upwards. Okay, it's moving vertically upwards. So when it is moving vertically upwards, what happens to the velocity? It will keep on decreasing. Okay, so initial velocity here will be 50. Why? Because as it goes upwards, the velocity will decrease. Final velocity here will be 20. So after a certain point, it reached over here. So here the velocity was 20 meters per second. That means it reached here. So this is the final velocity. What is the time? 3 seconds. So it reached from this position to that position. So it was at this position going upwards from 50 meter per second, slowly reduced to 20 meter. So initial velocity will be 50 and final velocity will be 20. Okay, now what is the acceleration? So here, same way we will write the formula. Acceleration equals to change in velocity upon time, v minus u upon t. V value here is 20. Can you see final velocity? 20. Initial velocity? 50 upon 3. So 20 minus 50 minus 30 upon 3. So the answer comes as minus 10 meter per second square. Why minus 10 meter per second square? Because acceleration is negative. So we had discussed that retardation or deceleration is called as negative acceleration. This was opposite to that of gravity. That's why your acceleration is negative, which is minus 10 meter per second square. I hope this is clear to everyone. Initial 50, final 20, and then the value we get it as minus 10. Acceleration will be negative here. Now the 12th numerical. I hope all of the numericals are very clear with you. Just go through it once properly and try to solve on your own again. Now here 12th numerical, a toy car is there which is moving with a uniform velocity of 18 km per hour and comes to stop in 2 seconds. Now it is moving with a uniform velocity means what? Initial velocity will be 18 km per hour and then it comes to stop suddenly, so final velocity 0 km per hour. Now here if you see the time is in seconds, so we need to find the value in meter per second. Acceleration also is in meter per second. So 18 km per hour equals to 5 meter per second. How? 18 into 5 upon 18, which is 5 meter per second. When we have to convert kilometer per hour into meter per second, we use this formula. Okay, now here what are we supposed to do next step? If final velocity is 0 km per hour, so we can take it as 0 meter per second also. So acceleration v minus u upon 2. So what is final velocity here? The final velocity will be 5. Okay, from where did I get this 5? 5 meter per second. Okay, here the final velocity will be 5 as well as minus 0, that is the initial velocity, upon 2. Okay. So here we can say that the answer is 5 upon 2, which is 2.5 meter per second square. Just give me 1 second. Okay, just make one correction here. The initial velocity which is there over here is 5 and the final velocity is 0. So here you will be writing it as 0 minus 5 upon 2. Okay, why? Because final velocity is 0 here, initial velocity is 5, 0 minus 5 upon 2. So which will be minus 5 upon 2, that is minus 2.5 meter per second square. Okay, this will be the retardation or the negative acceleration which is there. Okay, we will be just writing it as 2.5 and we can consider it as negative acceleration. You can write it in positive here. So this will be the negative acceleration or the negative value. Okay, so this is the 12th numerical. Fine. So here just the correction was 0 final velocity minus initial velocity 5, so it's minus 5 upon 2, which is 2.5 meter per second square. So this is the value of it. Okay, fine. Now let us proceed. Why I have taken final velocity 0 here? Because it is coming at rest after some time. Okay, so if first it was traveling with a uniform velocity 18 km per hour and then it is coming at rest. Okay, so this will be the final. So z final velocity 0 minus 5 upon 2 minus 5 upon 2, which is nothing but 2.5 meter per second square. That is negative acceleration, or we call it as retardation also, because here they have asked the retardation, that's why we have mentioned it as 2.5 is the retardation. Okay, now let's go to the next numerical, which is the 13th one. Now 13th numerical, I'll read it. A car accelerates at a rate of 5 meter per second square. Find the increase in the velocity in time 2 seconds. So if the car accelerates means what will be the acceleration? 5 meter per second square. How will you know that it's acceleration? Just see the unit of it, that particular unit in the numerical. So you will understand that it's acceleration. Acceleration 5 meter per second square. Increase in velocity you are supposed to find out. Time is given 2 seconds. So what will you do? Acceleration equals to increase in velocity upon time taken. Acceleration is 5, increase in velocity we don't know, upon 2. 2 is the time taken, so 5 multiplied by 2 gives me 10 meter per second. So increase in velocity is 10 meter per second. Once again, acceleration was given, time was given, so it's easy to find out the increase in velocity, which is 10 meter per second. Okay, now let's go to the 14th one. Now 14th numerical, a car is moving with a velocity of 20 meter per second, okay, and the brakes are applied at a rate of 2 meter per second. Okay, brakes are applied at a rate of 2 meter per second. So what will be the velocity after 5 seconds of applying the brakes? Now here let us see. First, initial velocity is there, that is 20 meter per second. So car is moving with a velocity of this. Now we have to find out the final velocity. What we are supposed to find out? The velocity after 5 seconds of applying the brakes. So here we know that retardation, the brakes were applied, so I have taken it as minus 2 meter per second square. Why I have taken here minus 2? Because it's the retardation. We know that the retardation which is given as minus 2 meter per second square. Now here we are supposed to find out the final velocity. Initial velocity 20 meter per second, we are supposed to find out the final velocity. Retardation is given as minus 2. So what will be the formula? Acceleration equal to rate of change in velocity upon time taken. So here I have v minus u upon t. acceleration, that's a retardation, I took it as minus 2 over here, which is equal to V minus 20 upon 5. So here minus 10, okay, minus 10 equals to V minus 20. So when this minus 10 goes there, it becomes plus 10. Or else simply what we can do over here is, we can just take the terms at one side. For example, this particular term I can take at this side. So minus 20 becomes plus 20, okay. So here you can say that minus 20 becomes plus 20, and this minus 10 will remain as it is, because minus 20 is going here, so it becomes plus 20. So plus 20 minus 10, which gives us V equals to 10 meter per second. So my final velocity is 10 meter per second. So here, this is how you can get the value for the final velocity. Understanding, the final velocity will be V equals to 10 meter per second. Okay, so that from this particular retardation, we have found this numerical. Okay, I hope it is clear. Okay, even if you don't give the sign minus 2 over here, even if you don't give the sign over here, you just have to then take it at the other side. Okay, fine. Now let's proceed to the next numerical. Now the next one, here the 15th numerical we are seeing. A bicycle initially moves with a velocity 5 meter per second and accelerates for 5 seconds at a rate of 2 meter per second. What will be its final velocity? So here the bicycle is moving with the initial velocity 5 meter per second, acceleration is 2 meter per second square, and the time is 5 seconds. We are here to find out the final velocity, same as the numerical 14. Acceleration equal to change in velocity, so A equal to V minus U upon T. So A is nothing but 2, V is nothing but, we have to find out, minus 5. 5 is nothing but initial velocity upon 5. So 5 2s are 10 minus V minus 5 equals to V minus 5. So here what I have done, I have taken this V this side, okay, this V I have taken here, so which will be minus 5, okay, this will be 5 plus 10. So what we are doing, we are just interchanging their signs, okay, we are just, see, when we interchange the signs, this is the result. Minus V I take this side, minus 5 will remain as it is, minus 10 comes here. So minus V equals to minus 15, which is what? V equals to 15 meter per second. So I hope this is clear, this numerical is clear with you, how I got this. Okay, finally now the last numerical, which is the 16th numerical. 16th numerical is given as, a car is moving within a straight line with a speed 18 kilometer per hour. So initial velocity, or we can say the initial speed, is nothing but 18 kilometer per hour. So we can give that, that is the speed. Then time taken is 5 seconds. It stopped in 5 seconds by applying the brakes. So brakes are applied in 5, and it is stopped after 5 seconds. You have to find out the speed of the car, the retardation or the deceleration, and the speed of the car after 2 seconds of applying the brakes. Okay, in 5 seconds it is stopping, again you have to find out the speed after 2 seconds of applying the brakes. So here, first speed of the car you can calculate in meter per second, 18 into 1000 upon 16 into 16, or else you can use that way also, that is what, 18 into 5 by 18, which gives me 5 meter per second. Then what is the retardation or what is the deceleration? Final velocity minus initial velocity upon time. What was the final velocity? 0, because the vehicle stopped. Minus 5, which is 5 meter per second, upon 5. What is 5? Time 5 seconds. So 0 minus 5 upon 5, we can take it as 1 meter per second. Since it is deceleration, retardation, already we can write it as positive 1. Okay, it's 1 meter per second, that's the retardation. Then the third part, you have to find out the speed of the car after 2 seconds of applying the brakes. So brakes were applied in 5 seconds, after that it covered certain distance. Okay, so what was the acceleration at that time you are supposed to, velocity at that time you are supposed to find out. So V be the speed of the car, so V minus U upon T, so V minus 5, 5 from where? From here, upon 2. So here we are supposed to find out the final velocity. So how will we find it out? So minus 1, okay, here I have written minus 1, it is the retardation. So V minus 5 upon 2, okay, so which is nothing but minus 2. Okay, minus 2 plus 5. So I have here also, I have just interchanged the signs. So how did I do that? So here I have shown you both the scenarios. If you're putting the minus sign over here, what will you get? Minus 2, minus 2, V minus 5. So here minus V, I took this side, so minus V equals to minus 5 plus 2. So minus V equal to minus 3, so V equal to 3 meter per second. And if you don't put the minus sign for the acceleration, okay, if you are not putting the minus sign for the acceleration, then it will be वन इंटू टू टू नॉर्मल टू टू इक्वल्स टू वी माइनस फाइव सो वी माइनस फाइव प्लस टू वी इक्वल्स टू थ्री सो जस्ट सी दिस पार्ट्स क्लियरली ओके वॉट इट इज़ एक्चुअली सो आई होप द न्यूमेरिकल्स आर क्लियर विथ यू नाउ इन द न्यूमेरिकल्स वेर एवर रिटार्डेशन इज गिवन फॉर एग्जाम्पल यू कैन सी दैट इन क्वेश्चन नंबर 11 ओके retardation is not given but acceleration is given so we have put here the sign as minus 10 meter per second in 11 minus 10 meter per second square but if you see the answer over here that is 12th one okay your 12th numerical if you see you have got the answer as minus 2.5 meter per second square but you have not they have not given the sign over here why because it is the retardation So wherever retardation is there, no need to give the signs. But in the numericals also, it is up to you. If you want to give the sign, also you will get the same answer. If you are not giving the sign also, you are getting the same answer as I showed you in the 16th numerical. How, when you give the sign, what is the answer? And when you don't give the sign, what is the answer? Okay, so wherever retardation is given, you can just write the value without the sign. And wherever acceleration will be given, you write the sign. You mention that it is negative. Okay, I hope this is clear with everyone. See here, you can see they have also specified, negative sign shows the velocity, so the retardation is 10 meter per second square. So negative sign also you can show, the negative sign shows the velocity which is decreasing with time and retardation is 10 meter per second square. Okay, I hope you clear. So you must be having a confusion that somewhere places I am writing minus and some I am not writing. So you can just keep it positive if it's only given retardation is given. Just mention retardation. If acceleration is mentioned, you can put the negative sign. Here also they have given the retardation. But answer what did we get? Answer I got it in negative. You can just see. Okay, here answer I got it in negative minus 1 meter per second square. But I have written in the textbook it is written 1 meter per second square. Why? Because it is the retardation. So you can just ignore the negative sign of this. Okay, I hope this is clear with everyone. Thank you so much and take care.